Kim Jong-un has arrived in Hanoi with his party of something like 8. They're the people that will be doing all the nuts and bolts of the negotiations with the American side. So you'll be seeing people like Kim Jong-un's sister, Kim Yo-yong. She's traveled with him before. She was the first North Korean to visit South Korea in the run-up to the Olympics last year. She was actually seen on a station platform in China holding an ashtray for the leader. But she's much, much more important than that, even though not at the very top of the summit grouping. You've got Kim Yong-chol, no relation of course, but he's one of Kim's right-hand men. He played important part in the last summit, and he's also going to be right there in the mix of it right now. Also traveling is North Korea's defense minister, No Kwang-chol. He is the man who's a three-star general, but at the last summit in Singapore, he saluted President Trump, and President Trump saluted back, and that caused quite a stir in America because people thought maybe he shouldn't be saluting the defense minister, an army general of somebody who is still an enemy country. Miss Kim isn't the only woman in the party. She's joined by Choi Son-hui, the deputy foreign minister. It's very unusual to have women at the top of North Korean politics. It's mostly male dominated. There are very, very few female members in the Politburo. Miss Cho also comes with a certain amount of infamy. Last year's summit in Singapore, she referred to ignorant and stupid comments by American Vice President Mike Pence, and that caused an uproar which could have derailed it completely. Ri Soo-yong, he's a veteran diplomat who looks after the International Department of the Workers' Party of Korea. He's also notable because he reportedly was the guardian of Kim Jong-un and his sister Kim Yo-yong while they were at school in Switzerland. There has been a surprise addition to the group, that's Kim Fyong-hai. He's a diplomat from the previous leadership of North Korea, that's Kim Jong-il, who died in 2011, and he's not been in the public eye for the last 8 years or so. So we're seeing this man for the first time in a long time.